Hello everyone, my name is Zenitsu and I'm back with another Digimon Spoilers video. So over the past couple of days we got a whole bunch of new and exciting cards to look at from the Classic Collection as it's being spoiled, so let's just get into it. But first, just as a quick little aside, we did get a couple of cards that were previously spoiled in their cleaned up versions and some alt arts of them, and we also got a couple of alt arts of some of the cards I'm going to be showing off today. So, getting into the spoilers, starting off with Metal Menemon. So, Metal Menemon is a black level 5 Digimon, and stats aren't anything too special, but it does have two really decent abilities. The first one is its innate ability, where when you Digivolve into this card, you get to reveal the top 3 cards of your deck, add one level 6 Digimon card with Machine in its type among them into your hand, and then trash the rest. So this is a pretty interesting because it is a digging type of ability where you're just looking for your high level machines, and I definitely really like this ability because it's pretty decent trying to help dig out your next level, so that way you could go right into it, and trashing the rest can mean a whole bunch of different things, all depending on the type of deck that it's going into. So it's not like it's the worst thing in the world, it's not the best thing in the world, it just depends on the type of deck that could be utilizing it. The cards from the trash. But it does have a pretty nice inheritable ability of a when attacking ability that it gives, where if this Digimon has Machine in its type, then you get to delete one of the opponent's Digimon with a play cost of 5 or less. So we know that Black has been playing around with removal more and more, and this is a really good inheritable ability that's continuing on Black's theme of removal, which is based on the cost of the card. So I definitely really like what this card is doing, and this card definitely has some decent potential. Next up, we have Metal Tyrannomon. So Metal Tyrannomon is another black level 5 Digimon, same stats as Metal Menemon, so nothing too special there, but this also has two abilities as well. So its first ability is another when Digivolving ability, where we get to, again, look at the top 3 cards of our deck and then add one level 6 Digimon with Machine and its typing among them to our hand and then trash the rest. So this is the exact same ability as Metal Menemon, and we'll see why this has the same type of ability. And then it has its own inheritable ability where during the opponent's turn, while this Digimon has Machine in its type, this Digimon gains the reboot ability. So this is pretty decent because we already know that a big part of Black's identity is utilizing blocker and reboot. So if the Machine, let's just say Machinedramon, you're Digivolving up into has blocker, giving it reboot just makes it that much more annoying just because that's just a very powerful combination of keywords to be playing around with on top of anything else that card could be doing, because there is just a whole bunch of reboot synergy cards in the game. So I definitely really like what this card is doing and all of the possibilities this card can bring. Next up, we have Andromon. So Andromon is, again, another level 5 black Digimon, same exact stats as what we just previously saw, and its top ability is also the exact same as all of the others we just saw, where we get a look at the top 3, add one level 6 Digimon with Machine and its type into our hand, and then trash the rest. So obviously, because we're getting a whole bunch of this type of ability, there is going to be a more dedicated deck that wants to be interacting with machines. So I definitely am curious on what that is going to be and what that's going to look like in the long run. But it does have its own inheritable ability where during the opponent's turn, while this Digimon has Machine in its type, then this Digimon gains blocker. So we already know that Tyrannomon is going to give reboot. We already know Andromon gives blocker. So it's definitely interesting to see the direction on what they want to be going, considering there are multiple ways to give your high-level Digimon blocker and reboot. It definitely is allowing you to create like a good Swiss Army knife of abilities, all depending on what your top end is going to be and how you're going to be utilizing those cards. But I definitely think that these cards are building up to something really interesting and something that'll definitely be a lot of fun to be playing around with. Next up, we have Megadramon. So Megadramon is a level 5 red Digimon this time. Stats aren't anything too special, but it can Digivolve off of red or black, so it's definitely following in the footsteps of the Megadramons that came in BT06. But unlike those Megadramons, this doesn't count as the other color, but it does have a nice on-play ability where you get to delete two of your opponent's Digimon with 3000 DP or less. So this is almost doing like a mini Volcanic Dramon kind of ability, except you're getting a lower level body and you're not being able to clear as many Digimon, but it can still clear out a wide variety of threats. So I definitely think it'll be interesting on how this card can be utilized because, again, it has an on-play ability, so it wants you to be hard casting it from your hand, but yet again, it also has an evolution pass in both red and black. So I'm a little confused on where this is going, but it definitely seems like it's a pretty decent card to be thinking about, again, all depending on the type of deck that it's going to be going in. But it does have a nice inheritable ability where during your turn, while this Digimon has Machine in its type, then this Digimon gains Security Attack plus 1, and that's pretty decent considering that Security Attack plus 1 is already just a very powerful mechanic and keyword to be working with because it just allows you to hit even harder and it allows you to pressure the opponent that much more efficiently and effectively with. Next up, we have Machine Dramon. So this new Machine Dramon, stat-wise, isn't really doing anything too special. He is a black level 6 with 11,000 DP and can Evo for 3. But the interesting thing about this card is he can Evo off of red or black. So that kind of further incentivizes you to be utilizing red and black as a color combination. So I definitely think just its ability to do that alone already makes it a pretty interesting Digimon to be playing around with. On top of which, it has 3 very powerful abilities that make it a very strong Digimon or could make it a very strong Digimon, all depending on how you utilize it and what cards you add into its deck. So his first ability is an on-play ability where you get to place up to 5 red or 5 black level 5 Digimon with Cyborg in their typing with different card numbers from your hand or trash as this Digimon's Digivolution source, and you get to gain 1 memory for each card placed. So there's just a lot to unpack with this first ability alone. So for placing 5 Digimon with Cyborg in their typing that's either red or black into his inheritable source, you get to gain a memory for each. So that's basically reducing his on-play cost from 12 down to 7, which is pretty decent for a level 6 body. And then on top of which, you're going to be gaining the benefits of any of the inheritable abilities from all of those Cyborg Digimon, and they do have to be different Cyborg Digimon. So maybe one Andromon could be, as an example, from this set, and one Andromon would have to be from a different set. So that's kind of what that is referring to, but the idea is you're just sticking 5 cards underneath him and gaining a whole bunch of very powerful inheritable abilities, because as we just saw with all of the previous cards just spoiled, that they were all Cyborg level 5 red or black Digimon that are all interacting with machines that are all giving machines just a very powerful ability to be playing around with on top of trying to help dig out your machines. So we could see that there is just a lot of baked-in synergy into the set, but even outside of the set, there's still just a whole bunch of different level 5 Cyborg Digimon that you could be interacting with and have a whole bunch of slew of different abilities you could be utilizing. So it really is a card that does reward you for creative deck building, and I definitely really like that first ability and what you could do with it. And then it even has a really nice second ability where during all turns, this Digimon's DP can't be reduced. So this ability is just really, really powerful because for a while, yellow was a very prominent color and DP reduction was just very hard to deal with as a whole just because of everything that yellow was doing. So this type of ability definitely seems like they are trying to hose on yellow a little bit more and more with each passing set just because of how powerful and how prominent that color was performing in the previous sets. So we are now seeing cards to try to hard counter that, even though it is falling off of the meta a little bit, it's still just a very powerful type of removal for the game to be having, and it is just functionally different than every other type of removal in the game. So we definitely need this type of ability, even though yellow's prominence isn't going to be as big as it once was. It definitely can still come back at any moment, and these types of abilities are just good types of protection to have because it's really only harming one color and it's not really impacting the rest of the game. But this second ability does play into the third ability, where during all turns, when this Digimon would be deleted, you may trash 2 level 5 Digimon from its Digivolution source instead. So this is just really good because now it can't have its DP be reduced, so you have to figure out other ways of deleting this Digimon, and when it is deleted, then it has the potential to even stave off its deletion by getting rid of its own inheritable sources to ensure that it's going to stay on the field. So it just looks like this is a very powerful and very interesting Digimon to be building a deck around, and I'm definitely curious to see where people will go with this. I already have some of my own ideas in my head already turning, but we still have the rest of the set to look at, and there could be more cards to support this type of strategy, and I really like where the direction of the game is going, utilizing all of these unique aspects of cards that we haven't really seen or played around with before. Next up, we got a new version of Gatomon. So this Gatomon, stat-wise, isn't doing anything too special for being a yellow level 4 Digimon, but what this Gatomon is doing is she has a nice inheritable ability of when attacking once per turn. If you have 3 or more cards in your security, then one of your opponent's Digimon gets minus 2,000 DP for the turn. So we already knew that yellow previously was interacting with having 3 or less cards in your security, but at the beginning they did play around with having 3 or more, so it definitely looks like they're going back to playing around with 3 or more, especially with how much healing that they just gave yellow from this set and the previous set to try to keep their security as healthy as possible. So I definitely think that with yellow just playing around with how its security wants to be and what its security numbers are, it definitely seems like it has a lot of really interesting ways that you could be building a yellow deck, and yellow is still a very strong color. It's just I don't know in this grand scheme of things if this card is going to be seen a whole lot of play, just because there might be some better cards that do either the same thing that are easier to trigger, or just different abilities that you actually want to be utilizing rather than some more deep reduction. So again, I don't know how good this card is going to be in the long run, but it definitely is nice to see them going back and playing with different aspects of what yellow was doing before. And then the last card that we got spoiled over the past couple of days is going to be a new version of Pyildramon. So this Pyildramon is following in the same footsteps as the previous version in terms of its stats, where it's just a blue level 5, 7,000 DP, can evo for 3 off of green or blue. And then it has a native ability to it and an inheritable ability. So what its native ability is a when digivolving ability. If this Digimon has a Digimon with 3 in its attributes, in its Digivolution source, then you get to unsuspend it. So this is just a very classic blue thing to do, just unsuspending so that way you could multi-attack is just what blue is kind of known for at this point, and there are just a decent number of free cards that this does interact with. So the big one it's going to be interacting with is going to be Vmon. We do have just a whole bunch of different Vmons, and the Vmons do have a whole bunch of different interactions and synergies with it just being able to be unsuspended. But in terms of the level 4s, it gets a little bit more limited, where so far, as of right now, we just have XVmon and Stingmon that this card could be interacting with if you don't have a Vmon or Wormon underneath them. It's definitely interesting to think what cards could possibly be coming in the set, so we probably could guess that we're going to see an XVmon in some way, shape, or form that's going to probably interact with this Pyildramon, so that way it could interact with the Imperial Dramons a little bit more cleanly, both the new one and the old one. So it's definitely a card to look out for, and it definitely has a lot of potential, all depending on the types of support that you're going to be giving it, and all depending on what of the other cards that are going to be in the deck, on top of the other cards that potentially could get spoiled in the set. And then on top of which, it has a very nice inheritable ability where during your turn, if this Digimon has Imperial Dramon in its name, then this Digimon is unblockable. And that's just really powerful because if we just look at the old Imperial Dramon as an example, then you could get an attack off uncontested after it restands. Yes, unfortunately, you don't get an additional attack because you don't have the other Pyildramon underneath it, but your attacks will be with jamming and they won't be blockable, so that way you could try to aggro out, deal a whole bunch of damage early on, and then utilize this Pyildramon to try to close out the game with Imperial Dramon on top of them. So it's definitely a really interesting ability to see where this is going to be going, and even with the new Imperial Dramon, it definitely seems really interesting because he could rest down the opponent's Digimon, and then depending on how you build the deck, it really kind of changes the way the card wants to be played, and this kind of follows in that same similar footsteps where really just depending on how you build the deck, the cards can perform completely differently. But I definitely like all of the new additions that this is going to be adding, and I definitely think this is going to be a pretty decent card to be utilizing with Imperial Jamon decks as a whole, mostly for the blue base, just because Dino Beamon I personally didn't think was that great. But again, they are giving you a lot of different tools to think about on all of the different ways that you could build these types of decks. And that type of diversity really allows you to be creative, and they're just giving you the tools to make as powerful of decks as you possibly can and just have a lot more depth in what you're going to be working with. So that's all I really have for this video. As always, feel free to tell me your thoughts down in the comments below. And down in the description below are different ways that you could support me in the channel. So one of those ways is I do have a TCG Player affiliate link. So whenever you use that affiliate link to buy cards off of tcgplayer.com, then some of the money will go to supporting me in the channel. And on top of which, I also do stream over on twitch.tv/Zenitsu. So following and subbing is a good way to support me over on that platform as well. And on top of that, I also do make and sell playmats over on Overcard Gamers on Facebook. So whenever you buy one of my designs through them, then some of that money will also help go to supporting me in the channel. And as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content, and I'll see you in the next video.